Hey, what is up, guys? It's Arodiad here. Welcome to our Pokemon Light Platinum Nuzlocke series, episode 15. And in the last episode, we made our way over here to this Duskull City. What is the name of this city, actually? I've kind of forgotten. Is there a way we can, you know, kind of speed out of the route? We made it to Dar Dusk City, and we did a lot of grinding, if you could tell from the grinding montage. So why don't we go through and go summary, not secret power. We have Buzzkill the Vespiquen, level 40 now, caught up with the whole team with Slash, Gust, Toxic, and Secret Power. I taught a Secret Power from our TM case for the simple reason that it didn't really have any good moves. Then it learned Slash, Gust is Gust, and Toxic is actually going to be quite useful. And then we have Substitute Flotion, level 40, with Flamethrower, Flame Wheel, Smokescreen, and Quick Attack, holding that Amulet Coin to get a bit more money. Oh, by the way, Buzzkill does have the Silver Powder, so when we do get a Bug-type move, we will be able to improve it. And I don't know if I said it already, but Flamethrower, Flame Wheel, Smokescreen, and Quick Attack. Then we have Gargeel, the Excadrill level 40, holding the Focus Band, maybe to come in clutch if something happens to Gargeel. With Metal Claw, Rock Slide, Earthquake, and Slash. You did hear right, we did get Earthquake on Gargeel. He learnt it by level up, which is awesome. Actually, I might put Earthquake into the primary slot. Then we have Wop the Sealeo level 40 with Body Slam, Aurora Beam, Water Pulse, and Hail, hoarding those leftovers because Wop is fret. Then we have Russell the Sceptile level 40 with Leaf Blade, Giga Drain, Quick Attack, and Cut, hoarding the Bright Powers. Hopefully our opponents can miss every now and then. And we have Barney the Eevee level 8, which is still not at max happiness, which does annoy me. Why don't you love me, Barney? Why don't you love me? And Barney has Tackle Tail, Helping Hand, and Sand Attack. So nothing really much going on with Barney, but these are the main five. And it took a very long time grinding up, especially against level 12s and things like that. But why don't we go down here, and I'm pretty prepared to go and take on the gym this episode, because the gym leader's ace is like level 40, and it's one of those telepathic ones. But welcome to Dar Dusk City Gym. The leader, Thomas, uses Ghost Pokemon. Use Psychic and Dark attacks to win. I don't have either of those, so what my plan is I know that he has bulky Pokemon. I don't know what, but ghost types are usually bulky, so I am planning to go in and Toxic everything. Because we learned Toxic by level up, which is awesome. But what, actually, why am I leading off Vespiquen? Because Buzzkill only has normal type moves. Let's give Wop some time to shine, because I'm pretty sure level 42, oh, what the hell? But I'm pretty sure level 42 is when Wop evolves. So Aurora Beam should be putting in some work. And look at that, Leftovers is just awesome. Water Pulse, kill. Wop, when you become a Walrein, I'm going to love you so much, so much. But Shuppet is down, Dusclops. How well do you take an Aurora Beam? You took that so well. You know what, let's go for Hail. Okay, you know what? I said, let's go for Hail. Oh my god, Wop. I said, let's go for Hail. Wop. I said, let's go for Hail. What the hell, Wop? I said, let's go for Hail. There we go. So that means that the next move that we do will kill. See, no, it does not. But there we go, fine. That wasn't so hard now, was it? Binette. You know what? Let's show off Russell. Why not? Because Russell can go and Leaf Blade it and kill it. There we go. See, I really need Wop to evolve, because we really need it. Oh, okay. What about down here? I don't really know what to do here. But Aurora Beam seems to be doing kind of the trick, at least. I really want to use Wop until he is level 42. Because when he's level 42, that is just going to be amazing. Let's go for Hail, because Haunter does our speed, and that way we can get some residual damage. Binette. Okay, Aurora Beam, 2 Aurora Beam should do it. There we go. Mean look. Oh, I'm not escaping, Binette. I'm not escaping. Okay, this Aurora Beam combo seems to be doing the job. Drip Limb. Here we go. Now, one more Aurora Beam, and that should take him. Actually, no, Drifblims are pretty fat. You know what? I lied. They're not really that fat. I kind of want to slap on the Lucky Egg, just for now. Just for now. Just so we can evolve Wop. You know what? That's what we're going to do. And we're going to use a Moomoo. Actually, no. Wop seems pretty good. And, wait. We haven't gone down this way. That way. This way. That way. This way. Wow. Okay, this might take quite a while. There's a guy down there. Okay, nice to see you. Sableye. I actually really enjoy Sableye as a Pokemon. I don't really think its Mega Evolution does it justice, personally, because I feel like, Prankstar is the way better ability to run on a Sableye. Because I know that Mega Sableye is a lot more bulkier, but still, Drift Blim. Okay, we should take that out, and we're almost out of Aurora Beams. This is not good. This is not good. We actually might go, and next time that we leave, we'll go heal up. I don't really know what to do. Up here? Nope. Okay, well, we'll use this time to heal up. This is going to take so long. I should have looked up a map if I knew. Ooh, this is going to take a while. But you know what? If this takes a while, then it's okay, because then you and me, we can just have a nice, decent conversation. Nope. That's not what to do. This way. This way. Oh, okay. New area. That's nice. Shuppet. Let's go for Water Pulse, because that will one hit kill. There we're level 42. How well does Stubbs take out Haunters and things like that with Flamethrower? Because we have a bunch of Flamethrowers. Okay, that's nice to know. How about Flame Wheel? Oh, that's even nicer to know. Drift Blim. How well do you take out a Drift Blim with Flamethrower? You just take it out. Okay, but off memory, it didn't evolve. I thought Wop Wop evolved to level 42. I'm going to Google this. I'm going to pull out the old Nexus 4 and search up Celio on my phone. And if the internet will ever load, I'm not uploading, so I don't know why it's being so slow. There we go. Bulbapedia, nature's best friend when it comes to Pokemon. And you know what? It would be the best friend if it decided to load. Okay, so maybe... Okay, so it loaded. It's level 44. Okay, well, I'm going to give Celio the leftovers back, because I don't want him to get too overleveled. And let's put Stubbs at the front. Because I know that Gardevoir's Earthquake, but a lot of Pokemon here tend to, you know, have Levitate. Okay. Let's think this through. Down will take me here, then right takes me here. Okay, so down right is not the right spot. So down bottom right. What does that do? That takes me here, and then down. And then if we go down left, and then we go down up. And, okay, so here, pretty sure it's left, no, here, down left, down right, what am I saying, that's down left there, and up, I'm pretty sure I just did that before, down right, oh my goodness, this is gonna take forever. This is literally going to take five ever. Any time with this would be nice, just to, you know, see where I am. Ooh, this is annoying me. This is annoying. If this takes more than like 1 minute, then I'll just cut this whole thing out, because this is kind of annoying. Just seeing. This is annoying. See, okay. This is the one thing I don't like about ROM hacks. They tend to make things that aren't really fun. And by that I mean that, there's like a bunch of rival battles and things like that. I enjoy ROM hacks, but things like this is not fun, because in like Sabrina's gym at least, there were ways to let you know where you kind of were, because you could see everything. This one, I have no idea where I am, except if I look. Okay, this, if we go down here, there's nothing. There's a guy here. You might have defeated me, but Thomas is strong. Does this take me to the right? Okay, did it? Okay, it does. Wait, I might have cracked the code. What if we go up? Okay. Down. We did not crack the code, guys. We did definitely not. Okay, you know what? I'm going to keep trying and search up on my phone. Hopefully a map to this. And I will be right back. Oh my goodness, that was annoying. It was just, okay, that was extremely stupid. Because the whole thing, I had to go like backwards and forwards and then enter in a portal and go back in the same portal. Oh my goodness, well pretty much our team looks like they're pretty decent. The ace is Gengar, and I'm pretty sure it's because we've got Gengar. But we have, not Thomas. I'm pretty sure it's not, I know it is Thomas. Welcome to Dardust Gym. I need to fight at full strength to defeat you. Okay then, I'm pretty sure you have, 4 or 5 Pokemon. Okay, you have 4. And Gengar is your ace. Drift Blim. Well, it would have been nice to lead off with Wop Wop, but I guess a Flamethrower could do the job. I know that Drift Blims are pretty fret, but will it take it? It does take baton part. Okay, Miss Magius. Well, I know that your special defense is pretty good, but your physical defense is pretty bad. But we don't have any physical moves, so I guess. Okay, Spite. No. So we're gonna lose a bunch more flamethrowers. Reduced it by 3. Okay, well, I guess we can take out this Miss Magius, which is good to know. That way, Miss Magius will be dead, and his sombrero looking, like, he just looks like he's wearing a sombrero. We will not see him anymore. Okay, Dusknoir. This is kind of scary. You know what? Let's go into Buzzkill and go for the Toxic, because I feel like this will be the best decision. And I know that Buzzkill can't do anything else except Gust. And Gust doesn't really do much, but you know what? We can Toxic it. And then what else does Dusknoir have? It's got the Thomas got the rest of the Pokemon that just baton passed, Drifblim and Gengar. That's what I'm guessing. So let's go into what do you have? Let's go into Gajul, because I'm pretty sure this guy carries pressure and not oh, why did I do that? Because the sand stream. No. I'm pretty sure this guy carries pressure. So, there we go. I'll just speed this up. Why not? Do I have any awakenings? I forgot to stock up on potions and things. Do we have an awakening? We do not have an awakening. Do we have a full heal? We do have 10 full heals. Okay, that's nice. Curse. I'm just speeding this up because I'm a bit scared. Let's go for an earthquake, and that took it out. Okay, so that's nice. Gengar, I do know this one carries Levitate, and it's a poison type, so no Rustle, no Vespiquen. Let's just go into Stubbs and flamethrow it, and then the rest will be Drifblim, and that will be history. So I was kind of stressed out for this gym for no reason. Well, but actually, Gengar is really fast and really strong, so I don't want to speak too soon. But hopefully Stubbs can shoot flamethrowers right out of his kneecaps and just take out this Gengar. It did not confuse right. Oh no, you're one of the. Let me guess, you got Perish Song and Hypnosis and Dream Eater. You're going to have that annoying moveset. Okay, you're going to heal up anyway, so let's go for a flame. Actually, please, just take him out, Stubbs. There we go, Stubbs. There we go. That's why I love you, Stubbs. You're amazing. Gengar is down, and then Drifblim's the last Pokemon. I don't want to stay in with this guy. I'm going to go into Gajil and Rock Slide it, because that's super effective. And you know what? That should be the day, because Drifblim is already weakened more than half. And the Sandstorm does range. Does rage. So Drifblim is buffeted by Sandstorm. And Rock Slide takes out Drifblim. And there we go. That is the fourth gym leader done. Pretty sure that's the fourth gym leader. So that's actually pretty awesome. Gajul gained 450 experience. Gym leader Thomas was defeated, but it was really incredible, Nick. Okay, that's nice to know. At least you understand, but you just earned the ghost badge. One other thing, this ROM hack does not have very creative names, but Nick got the ghost badge. Why'd I read it like that? But the ghost badge lets you use strength outside of battle to push around large rocks. Also, I have another gift for you. Obtaining TM30, that's Shadow Ball, I think. So you're gonna Shadow Ball. Powerful and explosive ghost move. Does anyone learn Shadow Ball? It is special in this gen, so the only one that can learn it is Barney, but that would be awesome to teach when it becomes an Espeon. But until then, I'm gonna hang on to it. I'm not gonna end the episode off here, guys, because it's only been about 14 minutes and I'm trying to get longer episodes done. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm actually gonna let Wop Wop get a bit over leveled, just so we can get a wall rain and then let everyone catch up. Because I'm pretty sure there's a tower up here and it was blocked off before. So yeah, okay, it's frozen. Oh my god, is that Lance? Hello, judging by your appearance, I guess you must be Nick. My name might be familiar to you. I'm Lance. I'm the champion of both the Kanto and Johto regions. I came to Guardian Tower because there are rumors that Team Steam is trying to steal some relic and learn about the legendary Pokemon. I'm looking into it now, but it'd be nice if you could help, Nick. Let's go, Dragonite! It'd be nice to help, Nick, but you know what? I'm just going to leave you out here. Let's go. But we can get a new encounter in here. Ooh, there's Ho-Oh. There's Lugia. And is there any other Pokemon when we go up here? No, there is a ball up here. It is an Aether. That's always nice. We cannot run in here, which is kind of annoying. But you know what? Can we run here? No, we cannot. So, Team Steam is definitely here. So, let's speed this up. We have a Scraggy. You may not have a fighting type move, but a Body Slam should kill you. It doesn't... Ooh! Thank goodness you missed. Let's go for another one. That should kill... There we go. That was scary. Mean Foo. That was definitely mean of you. You know what? Buzzkill can go for Gus. And... Damn, Buzzkill is so weak. Oh my goodness. We just need you to get a better move. Let me guess, you have a Mean Shower too? Do you have a Mean Shower? You have a Glammeow. Let's go back into Wop-Wop. Because Wop-Wop seems to be able to do his thing. I was about to say her thing. Body Slam. Hypnosis. Don't be like that, that Perugly. Don't be like that Perugly, please, where you... Okay, Attack Bell. Aurora Beam. Okay, no. I have bad memories with that. But, okay, do we go straight? We do not go straight. Actually, is there an item around here? This looks like a place where you'd hide an item. Okay, I was mistaken. But, oh, actually, first encounter is a Duskull. Ooh. That's not too bad. I feel like a Water Pulse is going to kill it. But I feel like Buzzkill can only hit with Gust. I feel like Gust isn't going to kill. Because it didn't even kill a Mean Fool, and that was super effective. And these guys are bulky. There we go, disabled. You know what? I'm not even going to use it anymore because Ultra Ball is going to catch you straight away, Duskull. That's awesome. And we're going to name you Frank. Because I did a Nuzlocke with my friend ages ago. And we had a Dusklops. And it was named Frank. So there we go. We are named a Duskull Frank. And there we go. Too easy. There's a Pokeball under here that I did see before. Premier Ball. It's like Oprah. You get a Premier Ball. Everybody gets a Premier Ball. Ghastly would have been awesome. Ghastly would have been awesome to have. But Luxio, let's go into Gargeel because of the electric move coming out. Ooh, Bite. I lied. Earthquake. Boom! Earthquake is awesome. Mean Foo. Buzzkill, you can do it. I want you to level up because you're kind of weak by now. Level 41, though. I'll take it. Rufflet. Wop-Wop because of your nice and powerful, beautiful Aurora Beam. See, look, but the thing is that the level jump in this game has been kind of crazy because we were versus people that were like level 24 or something like that, and now since we've taken on the gym, everyone's level 36. And the level jumps in this game is just crazy. It's just crazy. But we have more Team Steam, guys. We have a Scraggy. Let's go into Buzzkill because last time this guy... Was that Ice Smash? Or Ice Punch? I don't know what it was. But Smelling Salt, what are you? Hariyama! There we go, critical hit. I need you to get a better flying type move like Aerial Ace or like Wing Attack or something, Buzzkill. But I don't know what you learned. But again, this is a ROM hack, so it could be different. We have a Shuppet. I wouldn't mind using a Binette either. But TM04, that's Carmine. Don't we have two of those? We do have two of those. Can you learn it? No, but I know that Espeon will be able to learn that. I really want Espeon to be at full happiness. I mean, oh my god, too soon! Too soon! Oh my goodness, I miss Jabbers so much. But I know that Espeon can learn it, and I really want Eevee to get max happiness. Because if Eevee can get max happiness, then I will be a one happy man, because then we will get an Espeon, and I'll be able to train Espeon up. But we are one level away from Wop-Wop. You know what I might do? I know I cut myself off and say we're one level away from Wop-Wop evolving, but I might put Barney at the front and then just switch him out. That way, if he levels up, we can see if he's at max happiness. I wouldn't put my money on it, but you know what? We can check. Level 9, is he at max happiness? Is he at max happiness? Oh, actually, Pharaoh, number 21 plus 1. Oh, mirror move. That was kind of scary. You know what? Let's just keep going because Pharaoh is not that strong. Actually, I do enjoy Pharaoh more than Pidgeot. See, again, Barney level 10 is not max, which does suck. But I do enjoy it more than Pidgeot because Pidgeot is the one that everyone knows and everyone loves. But then you got... I forgot that we were also water type. We did outspeed before, so Aurora Beam will be able to take it out. Pharaoh, let's stay in. That's Aurora Beam, because last time you just had Peck. And you know what? This is okay, because now we're going to Moo Moo Milk it up. What was I talking about? I forgot, but I really want to buy some more Moomoo Milks. If you guys do know where we get Fly in this game, that'd be amazing, because I really want to go buy and scoop up some more Moomoo Milks. TM10, what is that? I know TM9 is Bullet Seed. TM10, is that like Hail or something? It is Hidden Power. Ooh, if there's another place where you can do the Hidden Power moves and check it out, that'd be awesome to know. But why don't we do the common question of the day, where, pretty much, I know it's a bit late in the episode, and I know I've been recording for actually quite a while. It's been about half an hour. Pretty much, common question of the day is going to be, we're not doing this. But common question of the day is going to be, what is your favorite TM? Like, God, Krogunk's kind of weak. Because out of all the TMs, you got to have your favorite. Mine either has to be Flamethrower or it has to be Earthquake. I feel like those are amazing. And let's just keep going for Gust. I might end it after this. I might make a run back and go and heal up our Pokemon. Please just go and wake up Buzzkill. Please wake up Buzzkill. Thank you. And next one will kill. Next one will kill. So, okay, you know what? No. We're done with this. Because I'm not losing Buzzkill. Let's go into Gargeel. Because we can go whip up a Sandstorm. Just with that nice souffle. Just whip it up. And we can Rock Slide and just take him out. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go and run all the way back with our tail between our legs. And can you please stop doing this, mate? The reason I don't buy repels is because I've only encountered a shiny Pokemon in the wild twice, and I really, like, I know that if you use repels, then you lose the chance of finding wild Pokemon, so I don't do that. But anyway, I hope you guys did enjoy this episode. If you did enjoy this episode, leave a like, favorite, comment, subscribe, do all that good stuff, really helps me out. Follow my Twitter if you haven't, link will be in the description below. Don't forget to answer the comment question today, which is, what is your favorite TM in the game? And yeah, don't really have much else to say. This has been Arodiad. I'll catch you guys later. Peace.